Hi, today I have a case study for you. It is a daughter's podcast with her poet laureate father, who's 83. The show is brought to you by the Your Family Stories system, which is everything you need to know to record a loved one's life story, just like this case study, and I'll have some free sections on that coming up, so stay tuned. If this is the first time you've come across Forever Young Autobiographies, it's where we learn to write life stories for family and friends so unique memories can live on. It'd be super if you could follow, subscribe, and like the show. So today's case study involves Dr. Treasure Shield Redmond and her Professor of English father is Eugene B. Redmond. Now they've come together to put out a podcast called The Memoir My Dad Wouldn't Write. Now, I love that name, that's really creative. So, the podcast has started in 2018 and they're up to about 24, 25 episodes. And it's where Treasure and her dad sit down in conversation. They're going through chronologically the events and happenings of his life. And she says this is really helps us understand how his life was shaped because he's a complex, he's an incredible, far from perfect man that she loves, she says. So we're going to sort of delve in a bit about this case study, this podcast, and we're going to find out some tips from Treasure that you can take and use in your own creative project. To start out, let's find out a little bit about how the project began. So as I said, Eugene had an incredible life. He was a writer, he was a poet, he was a professor, he was an activist, even a cultural worker. And he wouldn't write his memoir, so Treasure said she was mightily disappointed that she hadn't recorded the stories of her maternal grandmother. And she was really lucky in that she had a forthcoming elder here and her dad to do a project with. And she says, you know, how did she put this? She said he was verbose in a nice way. So it was a kind of a really good match there, that someone willing to talk. So she was quite blessed in that way. And being both writers, they were happy to collaborate on a creative project. Now, their friends and family were very supportive because they were both these creative types and it made sense that they would do something together. The feedback from the listeners so far has been really positive. One listener has said, "Look, I'm astounded by how open the conversation is, and I wish I could be like this with my own father." And Treasure said, another one said, "Look, I love this podcast. It's great, and I really encourage you to put it into a book. It's that good." So that was fantastic background to starting the show. But how do they actually get this done? Like, that's the nuts and bolts of this podcast. She says it's not rocket science. They live really closely to each other. She said around 4 miles. Treasure's a Mississippi native, so in America. She lives 4 miles close to her father, which is about in kilometers. It's about 6.5 kilometers. She just goes over, sets up her phone with the Zoom software, video software, and just records them in conversation. She says the hardest thing is getting time to sit down and make an event of it, to do the interview, because her father, even though he's, you know, in his 80s, he's still really busy, and so is she. So that was the challenge. But there's been a lot of rewards. Treasure says she's gotten to know and understand her father a lot more. And then it's been good in that he really wants to do this project in an honest way and while he still can, while he's still with it, really active and healthy. So that was fantastic. There's been some favorite parts to this project. Treasure says it's when she's been talking to her father chronologically and they come across a topic or a person that then is very timely to what's going on in the world now. And that sparked more conversations. For example, when author Toni Morrison died, her father was able to talk about knowing her. Also, he was able to relate about when he was in his teens and he heard about the lynching of Emmett Till. And that led to further conversation about high-profile murders of African Americans and that wider context of what's going on in the world now. She said that was really, really rewarding to see that happen. So that leads us to some tips that Treasure had if you're going to do something similar, whether that's starting a podcast or interviewing a loved one. Firstly, she says, don't let the technology hold you back. Start out simply, use your phone, use that Zoom software that she mentioned, and then you can upgrade your technology if you want as you go along. So don't let that hold you back. The second thing she said was to have a mission. So her mission in this project was to record her father's life chronologically. But she says you might have another mission. This could be perhaps maybe recording parenting strategies, or could be to do with spirituality, or maybe sort of a cultural thing like recording family recipes, that kind of thing. That's really important to have that mission. She says, look, she's so proud and excited that she's done this. She'd highly recommend others to do it. She says that, you know, recording the stories of elders is so important. It's like an investment of resources for future generations. So that's such a heartfelt call to action for us all, I thought. So to recap, we've talked about how they got started, how they do the recording, and some tips. And this is all to do with the creative memoir of Eugene B. Redmond, Professor of English. So I, you know, would love for you to start something similar as Treasure and her dad, flick that on-air switching and record some stories today. If you'd like to find out more about Treasure and her father's podcast, you can go over to my website at foreveryoungautobiographies.com/poet. I've got an article there. It's got some photos of the two of them and Treasure's family. Also, there's the image of the podcast and links to the podcast. So highly recommend that you go and have a listen to that. Again, drop me a comment. You can do it on this platform or you can do it over at the end of the article at the website. And send me an email if you like at foreveryoungautobiographies.com/contact. And the question today is, who are you thinking of interview or whose stories are you thinking of recording? I'd love to find out what's the project that you have in mind. So that leads me on to the Your Family Stories, which I mentioned earlier. And this is a whole system that I've created. I've been a journalist for many decades and I've recorded my grandmother's life story. She's 100. And I've documented how I did this in the Your Family Story system. So that's planning to interviewing a loved one. So setting that up, a bit like Treasure and her dad. And then holding the interview, and then what to do with all that material. There's so many different channels and ideas that you can put it onto these days. So I document that in the Your Family Story system. And I'm giving away the first few sections for free so you can take a quick look, see if it's for you. And you can get that by going to foreveryoungautobiographies.com/free. Put in your name, email, hit OK, and I'll send you all the details for that. So I will be back again soon with another topic. So if you've made it this far, please follow, subscribe and like the show so you'll know when the next one comes out. And until then, happy writing, everyone.